Good evening, students. So, as you know, this is an NTIC class that you are going to attend. So, already whatever the things that we have discussed in our chapter 1, that is chemical reaction and equation, first I will give some key points on this chapter, and followed by I will give some questions which are already being asked from this chapter in previous NTIC question. You have to solve that one and come for a live discussion in Zoom app. Okay? If there will be some connectivity problem, in order to clarify your doubts, you can directly call me over my phone number and can clarify your doubts. Okay? Now, coming to our chapter, chemical reaction and equation. As you know, the chemical reaction is characterized by or can be identified by change in color, evolution of a gas, or formation of a precipitate, or change in temperature. So already we have discussed these things in detail in our previous video. You can go to those links and can see those videos in order to have a better understanding. Like suppose in change in color, rusting of iron is a kind of the reaction in which change in color occurs, and so on, several changes are there. The types of chemical reaction, in that you can see here, slow and fast reaction, reversible and irreversible reaction, addition or combination reaction, and in addition or combination you can say that will be element-element reaction or compound-compound reaction, or element and compound both will react. Then decomposition, we have thermal decomposition, electrical decomposition and photochemical decomposition. Then we have displacement reaction. In displacement, we have maybe single displacement and double displacement. In single displacement, already I told you the more reactive element displaces a less reactive element from its compound in aqueous solution. And again, in double displacement, we are mutually exchanging the radicals. There can be, it will be neutralization reaction or a precipitation reaction. Then we have exothermic reaction and endothermic reaction. Where in exothermic, the heat is liberated, endothermic, the energy in the form of heat is absorbed. And we have not yet discussed about the redox reaction, which is a combination of like your oxidation and reduction reaction. So in this video also I will tell something about the redox reaction. Now the concept, as it says, oxidation means the addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen, and reduction means addition of hydrogen or removal of oxygen. So I am giving a simple example. Let's say carbon burns in oxygen to give carbon dioxide. So here we can say carbon get oxidized. Carbon undergo oxidation, because in carbon oxygen gets added up. Or I may tell you copper heated in air to form copper oxide. There copper get oxidized. Copper undergo oxidation, but simultaneously here one substance get oxidized, means the other substance get reduced, oxygen get reduced. So basically there are number of concepts in your redox reaction. One is there the addition of oxygen and removal of hydrogen. Then another one is they are called electron concept, that is the loss of electron is oxidation and gain of electron is reduction. Like you can say iron combining with copper sulfate to form iron sulfate and copper. So here you can say iron carrying no charge, and here it is carrying plus charge. So we can say iron changes to Fe++ by losing two electron. Iron loses two electron to form iron plus. So iron getting oxidized, but copper here plus to zero charge. So Cu plus changes to copper by accepting two electron. So copper get reduced. So oxidation means loss of electron, reduction means gain of electron. So in some reactions you will find also, if it is a displacement reaction, that can be also said as a redox reaction. So in broad I may say type of reaction you can classify, one is redox, one is non-redox. Okay, so the non-redox reactions are called as metathesis reaction, and the other one is called redox reaction. So whatever the assignment I have given, also I have given some questions on redox reaction. So if you are unable to do that, do not panic, that I will discuss also during your doubt clearing. And remember, whenever one in a redox reaction, the substance which is oxidized is called reducing agent or called reductant, and the substance which get reduced is oxidizing agent or called oxidant. There is another concept of like your oxidation number concept, but I am not going to that. So whatever the key points or the things that I have told regarding the chemical reaction and equation, based on that, all those concepts, I have given the questions that have been already there in your previous year, other state, the NTSC questions from this chapter, whatever the question asked, I have given that. So you solve that one in this period only, and you submit your answer, then we'll go for a live discussion. Thank you.